Sammy Lipping is just coming out here, but here's a guy that's got bruises on his face. He's got stitches in his head. He's a hell of a mess.
Well, he was able to escape the rules. He was able to escape the Royal Rumble with his title, but he wasn't able to escape Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels' Sweet Chin Music. After Michaels had lost a ton of blood, Michaels nor the game were able to rise before the referee's 10 count. Officially in the record book, it'll go down as a draw. Very disappointing for Shawn Michaels fans, no doubt about that. But that's why a lot of folks are saying, I've heard some guys talking today, that they believe that the game's time is drawing near, that Shawn Michaels should be the World Heavyweight Champion as we speak.
Well, I'm sure Triple H never dreamed in a million years that he would leave the ring last night after the Royal Rumble on a stretcher, and that's just what happened.
Wow, he looks bad.
Look at that eye. His right eye. Ugh.
Last night, two men stood in this ring. They scratched, they clawed, they fought, and they bled buckets for what they believed in. And that is the World Heavyweight Championship. Shawn Michaels, you said last week that the whole thing might come down to 1 second. Well, when it came right down to it, Shawn, and that 1 second was a reality, you didn't have what it took. You couldn't stand on your own two feet, Shawn. And that's why tonight, I stand here before all of you and the world as still the World Heavyweight Champion.
The irony of that is that Shawn Michaels wasn't standing on either. Wait a minute. Well, there you see him. He was the number one contender going into the Royal Rumble. In my heart, Shawn Michaels is still the number one contender for the Heavyweight Championship. And you talk about another man that put his heart and soul on the line in the last man standing match. It was Shawn Michaels. Not to take anything away from the game, because he did as well, but take a look at Michaels' face.
Yeah, you talked about a car wreck. Well, Shawn Michaels was in that same wreck.
What must the bodies of these two men feel like? What must be going through their minds right now?
What do I gotta do to you, huh? What's it gonna take, Shawn, huh? What do I gotta do to you? What do I gotta do to you? Haven't you had enough yet?
You and me, we haven't even gotten started yet.
Oh my God.
Oh, God. This crowd erupting here. Pop the wheelie. Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Watch it.
As only the Texas Rattlesnake does. Making his way to the ring and reckless abandon.
Reckless abandon is right.
This crowd erupting with Austin's arrival. Well, let's not forget that the World Heavyweight Champion, and in my view, still the number one contender, Shawn Michaels, are standing in this very ring.
Well, the Sheriff Austin is here to lay down the law. What do you think he's got on his mind, JR? Other than beer.
Austin saluting this crowd for braving the elements. We've got a huge crowd here tonight, and the crowd saluting the sheriff back.
Just a second.
You know, it's a damn shame that last man standing match wound up in a tie. Because the rules say in the event of a tie, the champion retains the title. The bloodshed, the brutality, the carnage that took place in this ring last night reminds me of something right out of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Oh. Good point.
Shawn Michaels, I said this once. I'll say it again. You deserve a damn rematch.
Damn right he does. Damn right he does.
Triple H doesn't think so.
Problem is, I ain't out here to make matches. I'm out here to uphold the law. Now, the rules state that the winner of the Royal Rumble goes on to WrestleMania to face the champion. Now, what the rules don't state is which champion that winner faces. Shawn Michaels, like I said, you wrestled your ass off last night. You wrestled one hell of a match. But you did not win the Royal Rumble. Chris Benoit did. So right now, I'd like the winner of the 2004 Royal Rumble to come out here to this ring.
I could tell I'm the last person either one of you expected to see. You know, last night, both of you went through hell fighting for that World Heavyweight Championship. Well, so did I. You know, for 18 years, I fought to be the best. And it took me 62 minutes to beat 29 men, to get the opportunity to face the best at WrestleMania. Now, whether that's you, Shawn Michaels, or you, Triple H, at WrestleMania, I will fulfill my destiny. I will be the next World Heavyweight Champion.
What the? How the hell can that be? Is Benoit saying he wants to wrestle for the World Heavyweight? Well, that's what he's saying. Austin said, and as the rule is, that the winner of the Royal Rumble match will meet the champion at WrestleMania, but as far as I know, it doesn't say what champion at WrestleMania.
And I think Benoit just made it plain that he wants to wrestle for that championship that is around or on the shoulder of Triple H.
I can't believe what we've seen. I can't believe what we've heard. This is astounding.
Is this right?
You know, Chris, I appreciate the warning, but I am well aware of who I've got to deal with here on Raw. You know, I came here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to be the best. And no one is going to stop me from winning that world title at WrestleMania. You know what? If Triple H seems to think or feel different, well, he's just gonna have to prove me wrong.
Well, maybe you're right, Chris, and maybe you're right, but have you ever thought that maybe the biggest obstacle facing Chris Benoit is Chris Benoit? I mean, you've heard all the critics. Chris Benoit, the greatest technical wrestler of all time. But hey, he can't win the big one now, can he? He just can't win the big one. You know, I used to feel that same way. I used to have the same critics say the same thing about me until I won the Undisputed Championship and became the first Undisputed Champion ever. But the bottom line is, Chris, you still haven't won the big one now, have you? And I know you've heard the people talking. You've heard the people in your head. A lot of people don't think you have what it takes to be a champion, Chris. A lot of people think you just don't have it. People in this arena think it. People in the back think it. Hell, the greatest world champion of all time thinks that. As a matter of fact, let's look at the Jerrytron 5000 and hear what someone said about you just last week at the Royal Rumble. Check it out.
You may be the greatest technical wrestler alive. You're Chris Benoit, all man.
But Chris, everybody knows you take a second every time you go out there.
You grab that big brass ring, you pull it down, but somehow it slides out of your hand.
You know, as far as Ric Flair is concerned, I've got a ton of...
This is Raw. And there's only one guy around here that rules the roost. That's Triple H, the World Heavyweight Champion. And he lives by a motto that I made famous, to be, woo, the man. You gotta beat the man, and that ain't gonna happen.
You say Triple H is the man?
Yeah.
Well, I say you're absolutely right. And at WrestleMania 20 in New York City, I will have the privilege of fighting the man. But right now, I couldn't think of a better privilege than to go one-on-one with the one and only Nature Boy.
The sheriff is in town.
Stone Cold, he's here.
Hey, Sean. What's going on with you? There's something about you just completely different. You down in the dumps just because Chris Benoit is here on Monday Night Raw? You maybe figure you're out of the world championship picture? Is that what I'm getting out of you? Because that's what I feel.
It is what it is, Steve.
Oh, well, you know what? I said it once, I'll say it again. You deserve a rematch for the world title. You know, so basically what I'm asking you is, what are you going to do about it?
What do you mean, what am I going to do about it? I'm not going to do anything about it.
Well, Shawn Michaels ain't going to do nothing about it. Here's a guy, okay, you've never said no to anything that's ever been asked of you here. Or else you never would have been one of the greatest champions of all time. To come back from the back injury that you came back from.
What do you want from me? Benoit won the Rumble. He's in, and I'm out. It's that simple.
I'll make it real simple for you. You want a shot at the title? Do something about it.
Wow.
Sean. What are you doing?
Cleaning Hunter's blood off my boot.
Why?
Is that supposed to scare me? Because it doesn't. Look, man, I know you're frustrated because you know you're never going to get another shot at the world title again. But listen, man, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do to you tonight. I'm going to take you in that ring, and just like I did to Mick Foley earlier today.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do, Randy? You're going to hit me with your belt? You're going to hit me with your
no,
belt?
No, I'm not, Sean. I'm not going to hit you with my belt. I'm going to beat you and further cement myself as being the legend killer.
You know what? You need to be incredibly, incredibly careful with me tonight.
Because if you're not, it's gonna be your blood on the end of my boot. I promise you.
You know, there's an old saying, be careful what you wish for, you just might get it. Well, Chris Benoit, understand something, you are now in the big dance. You have hit the big time, and both you know it, and I know it. The reason you're here is because there is only one world champion, one true world champion. And if you're gonna go after it, you're gonna go after the big daddy. You want the one that means you were the best. Well, Benoit, that's why you're here. But understand what that means. Next week, you and I are gonna come in this ring and we are gonna sign contracts. And once those names are on those dotted lines, there is no turning back. Because once we sign those contracts, it becomes official. At WrestleMania, it will be Chris Benoit going up against the best that there is, the game, for the World Heavyweight Championship. And Benoit, you need to realize that when most guys get in the ring with me, real quick, their dreams become nightmares. Now, Benoit, I saw what you did to the world's strongest man earlier. I was in the back just now. I saw him with his arm half hanging out of the socket. Real impressive. But let's see how impressive you are next week against, let's say, somebody like the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. 16 times heavyweight champion of the world. And, you know, there's a lot of similarities between Flair and myself. Both born and bred to be the best. Both groomed to handle the pressures of being the world heavyweight champion. Benoit, right now I want you to watch, and I am gonna show you what it means to be the absolute best at what you do. I'm gonna show you what it means to be the world heavyweight champion.
Randy Orton, who relates dispatching the World Tag Team Champions to help Randy Orton out of this hellacious predicament.
Wait.
Hey, come
what
on.
Is Triple H doing? We got Shawn!
Triple H with a cheap shot on Shawn Michaels, who just beat Randy Orton, and now the game. This is the Royal Rumble revisited. Right hands for the World Heavyweight Champion on Shawn Michaels.
Hey!
And wait a minute.
Hey!
There's another number one contender. Take a shot at him, Triple H. What's stopping you, Tent? What's wrong with the game? Is he gutless tonight?
Has he lost
his guts?
Tell us, coach.
Triple H is just assessing the situation. He has the guts. We all know that.
This is a situation to assess, all right.
He's biding his time. Triple H
biding his time for what?
He backs down from no man.
He's backing out of the ring like he's got the limber tail, if you ask me. The world's heavyweight champion had ample opportunity to get himself
a
number one contender. But he didn't.
You just made a big mistake.
You heard the game right there. Chris Benoit just made a big mistake. It will come a time when Triple H teaches Chris Benoit a lesson.
Well, maybe the game just isn't going to go one-on-one with Benoit and put off the inevitable that's going to happen at WrestleMania.
Benoit extending his hand to Shawn Michaels. Benoit, the number one contender for the heavyweight title. Shawn Michaels somewhat hesitant.
Oh, look, there he is. I knew he was watching.
Come here. Hey. You go tell Bischoff to get that ring ready. You go tell Bischoff. That contract signing with Benoit is next. Hold on a second. Chris Benoit. You look good, Chris. You look calm, ready, confident, strong.
But I know the reality. The reality is feeling a bit queasy inside, right? Stomach's in knots, your knees are weak. It's okay. It's nervousness. It's all right, it's understandable. It means you accept and understand why you're here today. It means you understand that tonight you look right from the edge, you look over, and you're gonna make the decision of whether or not you should jump off. The question is though, Chris, if you jump, will you land on your feet or will it all be over? Chris, I want you to imagine something. I want you to imagine what it's gonna feel like that night. Madison Square Garden. WrestleMania 20, Chris. The main event for the World Heavyweight Championship. The one championship that means that you are the man. The championship that means you're the best. It means that you are the king. And you know that. That's why you're here. That's why you left to come here, because you want to be the best. You want to beat the best to be the best. So imagine what it's going to be like that night, Chris, when you stand in the middle of that ring and they raise your hand up over your head in victory, and it all washes over you. Imagine the feeling as all that cheering washes over you, Chris, and you feel that rush inside your body. It's justification. It means that all those years, all those grueling nights in the gym, all that time in the ring in Japan, in the US, all over the world, it means that all of it in that one moment all becomes worth it. Think about it, Chris. When you stand in the middle of that ring and you hold what might as well be your life over your head, and 25,000 fans stand on their feet and they chant your name, Benoit, 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 Benoit. Just like that. Can you feel it? Snap out of it, Chris! Because it's a real nice dream, but this is reality. And reality says that you will choke. Reality says that at the end of that night, you're gonna be sitting alone in a locker room. No one there with you, by yourself. No one to pat you on the back, no adulation, no fans chanting your name. You will sit in a chair alone, staring down blankly into your bag in the space that you had so nicely reserved for the World Heavyweight Championship belt so that you could bring it home. Only that spot will be empty, Chris. Just like what's left of your career. Think about it. At WrestleMania, 18 years, a lifetime of blood, sweat, and tears will all be for nothing. Absolutely nothing. Hold on, Chris, hold on, hold on. You see, opportunities like this, they come once in a lifetime, and you have to ask yourself, is it worth it? Huh? Is it worth it to lose it all? Is it worth it to look in that mirror that night before you step in the shower, look yourself in the eye, and know that it's all over, that it's done? Is it worth it to you, Chris? This is the opportunity of a lifetime. This is what dreams are made of. But this is not a dream, Chris. This is reality. This
is reality. I am reality.
He's a son of a bitch if you ask me.
Hey, hey, hey.
So, you go ahead and sign your paper, Chris. No pressure, kid. No pressure.
No pressure?
Look, check. I know this is a huge, huge moment for you. And the last thing I want to do, Benoit, is rain on your parade. I, more than anybody, can appreciate what you've been through. You went through 29 men at the Royal Rumble, and you have earned this. You have earned a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship, and I respect that. You see, the thing is, I just assumed you would take care of your business on SmackDown. And I've got to be honest with you, man. I think you probably should have, because you need to understand something. The issue with Triple H and myself, it isn't over with. It isn't over with by a long shot. You see, this thing between he and I, it far eclipses any dream, any contract, any piece of paper. This thing has been nearly 10 years in the making, Chris, and I am this close to finishing it. And finish it, I will. And I'm gonna do it, whether anybody likes it or not, on the biggest stage of them all, WrestleMania 20, Madison Square Garden. And I'm gonna do it, Chris, for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Shawn Michaels, I've got absolutely nothing but the utmost respect for you. And I could talk for anyone and everyone sitting in that locker room. Hell, I could talk for everyone sitting in this building. In saying that, I will be the last to deny you your right to finish your issue with Triple H. It's just not going to happen at WrestleMania 20. You see, I'm going to sign this dotted line right beside Triple H's. And at WrestleMania 20, it is going to be Chris Benoit versus Triple H for the world title. It's going to be me, not you.
Oh! Oh my God! My God, did you see that? Michaels just kicked Benoit into another lifetime.
I came straight to this ring from Eric Bischoff's office, where I asked him the question who I would be facing at WrestleMania. And Eric Bischoff tells me,
gee, Triple H, I just don't have an answer for you today.
Well, you know what, Eric? That's just not good enough. Because I've got Chris Benoit breathing down my neck after winning the Royal Rumble, jumping ship to the big leagues and coming on Raw, and laying legal claim to the fact that he's got a shot at WrestleMania at the World Heavyweight Championship. And then I've got Shawn Michaels, who super kicked Chris Benoit and sign his name on a dotted line of a contract that says Shawn Michaels has legal right to face the World Heavyweight Champion at WrestleMania. And the lawyers can't seem to make a decision as to who is right. And I can see where this is going, because it doesn't take a genius to figure this out. It goes back to WrestleMania 10, and I'll refresh your memory if you don't remember. Yokozuna defended the title twice in one night against two totally different opponents and ended up losing the World Heavyweight Championship. Well, that will not happen at WrestleMania this year. Because this is WrestleMania 20, the biggest event in the history of this business, 20 years in the making, the biggest of all time. So I am demanding, as the standard bearer of this business, as the World Heavyweight Champion, I am demanding that Eric Bischoff come to this ring, show me the respect that I deserve, and tell me who I will be facing at WrestleMania. Now, Eric, this is live TV, and I'm not gonna wait out here all night, but I will wait out here until you come. Here we go.
Triple H, you have every right to be agitated, every right in the world. And quite frankly, I agree with you. There is no way the World Heavyweight Champion should be expected to defend that title twice in one night. I absolutely agree with you, which is why I've been talking to those attorneys. And I'm trying to sort
through the lawyers, Eric. I want an answer, and I want it now.
Oh. All right, I've been thinking about this. And what if I cancel tonight's match between Chris Benoit and Shawn Michaels? Hear me out.
Wait a minute.
Just hear me out.
What if?
Hey, shut up and listen to him. I'm trying to get an answer.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Listen to me. I'll replace that match with a match for the World Heavyweight Championship.
What the hell are you talking about? What are you talking about?
No, hear me out. Think about it. You're the champion. You'll have your choice. You can either take on Chris Benoit or Shawn Michaels. It's totally up to you. And let me ask you. All right, we'll get to that. And the winner of tonight's match will go on to WrestleMania 20 and defend that title. It's all figured out. So let me ask you people, do you want to see Triple H defend his World Heavyweight Championship right here in Bakersfield live tonight?
I don't know. People seem to really want that. I mean, is that what you people would really want? I mean, you tell me, is that what you people would really want to see me defend the World Heavyweight title right here tonight in Bakersfield? You know what, Eric? That's not a bad idea, except for one thing. You've obviously mistaken me for somebody who gives a crap what these people think.
Oh.
So let me just clarify for all of you. I don't give a crap what you think. I do what I want to do when I want to do it.
You suck.
Bischoff, I want you to give me an answer. What am I gonna do at WrestleMania? Because I don't give a crap what these people think. It doesn't matter to me.
This is out here 19 years worth.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, Benoit. I understand you're upset, but you're pissed off at the wrong guy. I'm not the guy that super kicked you in the face.
Oh. Uh-oh. Rather brazen.
You shut your damn mouth. I've listened to what you've had to say. I've listened to you run your mouth. Now this is about me. And I've got one thing to say.
Oh! Oh! What's he doing? Benoit sold in the world's champion. Benoit lacing in to Triple H.
He didn't say anything. He just started beating the hell out of the champ.
Benoit's axe is speaking louder than anything he can say.
Get out of there, Triple H.
Now Triple H turning the table. Crossface on the champion!
Get help out here! Get help out here!
Benoit's got the crossface on the champion. The wait!
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Here come the rest of Evolution and Benoit. Doing the only thing that he could do with three men running to the ring. Benoit just laced into the world's champion and started ripping and tearing at the shoulder of the champion.
For you, baby. No, screw that, Hunter. Let me go find Benoit. Let me find him. I'll bring him back to you in one piece.
Hey, calm down. All right, we got all night long, to get to Chris Benoit. I guarantee he's gonna get his before the end of this night. These two got a tag team title match right now. Randy, you go with him. You make sure nothing else goes wrong tonight.
Cool. Yeah.
You understand me?
Yes, I do.
Get him.
The man. My man, buddy. Come on, man.
Hunter.
Hunter, man. Don't worry. I got it all under control, man.
I know you do.
You have no idea what I want to do to you right now. But you will, because tonight, I'm gonna show you the same respect you showed me last week. I want you to think about that.
Whoa! Now Benoit says now we'll put an exclamation point on the end of this. Hey. Heavyweight champion Triple H felt the crossface earlier tonight, and he damn sure didn't like it.
Well, he's allowed to come out here if he wants to. I mean, he's going to be facing one of these men at WrestleMania. He's allowed to get a good close ringside view of this action. And he's got a scout of the
back. Triple H made his appearance.
Yeah. Did that look a little fishy to you? Triple H all of a sudden shows up when Shawn Michaels is in dire straits, and the next thing you know, Shawn Michaels wins.
And what the hell is going on here? Now Triple H is helping Shawn Michaels up.
Wait a minute, Jared. Do you know what you're
doing? Wait. No. No.
Any kind of alliance there.
Michaels are defenseless. Just got the damn pedigree after beating Chris Benoit.
You were wrong, JR. I know what you were thinking. You were thinking it was a setup. You were thinking that Triple H and Shawn Michaels were in this thing together, weren't you?
Well, it looked that way to me. champ is here.
Watch it!
What the hell else gonna happen here tonight?
Look out, Triple H!
Now what?
It turns out Eric Bischoff made a decision regarding the world title at WrestleMania, but I guess he was too afraid to come out here and tell you to your face because maybe he might piss you off. But since I don't give a rat's ass what you think, I'll come out here and make the announcement myself. So for the first time in history, the World Heavyweight Championship will be decided at WrestleMania, Madison Square Garden, March 14th. In a triple threat match.
What, Todd? What? Oh, my God.
Triple H versus Chris Benoit versus Shawn Michaels.
Oh,
and that's the bottom line, the Stone Cold said so.
Triple H is beside himself. Triple H can't believe it. Get it, Triple H.
Last week, Stone Cold Steve Austin came out here and informed the world and informed me that at WrestleMania, for the first time in history, the world title was going to be decided in a triple threat match. That it was going to be Triple H versus Shawn Michaels versus Chris Benoit. Now, I got to admit it. I freaked out. I was pissed off. I was probably madder than I've ever been in my entire career. Until I had time to go back and think about it. And then I realized, what else should I expect? After all, isn't that what you do? Isn't that what they always do, is stack the odds against me? It wasn't until Ric Flair pointed out to me just who the hell I am. He pointed out to me that I am Triple H, that I am the game, that I am the World Heavyweight Champion. But hell, hey, I'm only human. Sometimes even I can forget how great I actually am. Now, Am I happy?
Wow. Foul mouth crowd.
You see, that's the thing. Because as hard as it is for me to accept how great I am, it's gotta be killing all of you. Because no matter what you put up against me, I come out on top. Day after day, week after week, month after month, year after year, opponent after opponent, obstacle after obstacle, but yet I stand here every week, the World Heavyweight Champion. Now, am I happy about the fact that I've got to defend the world title against two different men at one time in a triple threat match at WrestleMania? No. Am I happy that I can lose the world title without even getting beaten at WrestleMania? No. But is this going to be the end of Triple H? Is this going to be the night that I fall? Is this going to be the night
that they knock the king off his throne? Is this gonna be the night that it's
game over?
No. No, because this is WrestleMania 20. This is the biggest event of them all, the granddaddy of them all, the ultimate spectacle. This is the biggest night in all of our lives. This is the biggest night in my life, and this will be the biggest night of my career, because I will rise to the occasion like never before. I will go to WrestleMania, and against all odds, I will beat the icon, the showstopper, the legend of Shawn Michaels. And I will beat the greatest technical wrestler alive today in Chris Benoit. And I will stamp my place in history at WrestleMania when I prove to the world that I am everything that I say that I am. Because once again, I will prove, just as I have done over and over and over, that I am the best wrestler in the world today, that I am the world heavyweight champion, that I am the game, and that I am that damn good.
Wow. With all of Evolution in there.
Well, Triple H, the fact of the matter is, you are the world champion. And to be able to call yourself the world champion, you've had to beat nothing but the absolute best. I respect that. You like to call yourself the game. Hell, you even like to say that you are the greatest world champion alive today. Well, since I've come over to Raw, that's all I've heard from you. There's a hell of a lot of talk. Talk, 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 talk. And I'm sick and damn well tired of listening to you run your mouth. The time for talking is done.
Really, the time for talking is over. You see, Benoit, you come across as a real tough guy. You like to come out here and tell everybody how tough you are? I'll tell you what, why don't you step in the ring right now and show us how tough you are?
Huh? That wouldn't be very smart.
Well, that's a fair challenge.
There's four guys in the ring.
Go ahead, Big Bad Benoit.
Benoit's not stupid.
You step in the ring with Evolution and show us all how tough you are.
Yeah.
Because what I think is, you say I talk a lot, I think you're a lot of talk. We're all standing right here. The fact is...
Uh-oh.
Hey, wait a minute.
What about an equalizer?
No, wait a minute.
There's 4 men in the ring, and Benoit stepping right into the mouth of the lion's den.
Well, I guess so. He's got a metal chair in his hand. He's got a weapon.
Well, there's 4 men that threw to me, Benoit. You're damn right he's got a weapon.
This is about to get good.
This is about to get real ugly.
Yeah, you better start swinging that chair.
Hits it from behind.
There you go.
And now look at the pack of ravenous dogs.
I thought you said Benoit wasn't stupid.
Look at these carnivores. Triple H.
He's not looking like the sharpest knife in the drawer right now. Hey, wait a minute.
Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels? What is Shawn Michaels doing out here?
Shawn Michaels getting him some of Evolution. Scattering.
And
Benoit! Benoit got the cross face on Michaels!
What's that about?
Remember Michaels with a super kick on Benoit last week? And now Benoit with a crippling cross face sunk in deeply and tightly on HBK!
Now nobody enjoys a good fight more than Stone Cold Steve Austin. But as sheriff on this show, I'm out here to enforce the law. And the law states that there's supposed to be a match tonight. So before Evolution or anybody else decides to get back in this ring, we're gonna have that match. And that match is gonna be Chris Benoit versus Batista. And I'll serve notice to you right now, if anybody from Evolution or anybody from the back for that matter decides to get in this ring during that match, they will not make it to WrestleMania 20.
Oh.
Not only is that the law, but that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
What kind of a threat is that?
He's got a... Batista being tortured! Batista being... He tapped! Batista taps!
I can't believe it!
Benoit!
Benoit shows us time and again that the Crimson Crossface can beat anybody, any size. Mark Henry on the sideline for 6 months thanks to Chris Benoit and Batista for the first time that I can ever remember in his career, tapping out, and it was at the hands of that man who just may be the next heavyweight champion of the world.
I still can't.
Sean, excuse me, Sean, just one quick question if you don't mind. Do you honestly think that you and Chris Benoit can coexist tonight against Evolution's Batista and Randy Orton?
You know, we're facing one half of the most dominant unit in our business today. You'd think we'd have to coexist just to make it to WrestleMania. But if I'm to answer your question honestly, Coach, I don't think so.
Gentlemen, you have both told me that you cannot trust each other in your tag match later on tonight. So I ask you both, what are your chances against Evolution's Batista and Randy Orton?
Well, Shawn Michaels and Chris Benoit as a team would be unstoppable. But somehow, my partner seems to be super kicking me every time I turn around. But make no mistake about it, Coach. I will be at WrestleMania, and I will be walking out.
That is exactly why you keep getting super kicked in the face. Keep going, Benoit. Keep going.
Yeah, I will keep going.
I don't know how many times I have to tell you.
This is between Triple H and myself. If you don't watch it, it's now going to get personal between you and I. I got news for you. As much as I respect you, as much as you deserve this, you are in my place. And I'm not having it, my friend. You're going to take care of it. It's real simple. If you finish this right here, we can take care of it out there. The choice is yours. After you. I sent you up and down their spine.
Just a sexy boy. And taking look at Batista taunting Michaels. Taking Benoit just close enough to really taunt Shawn Michaels.
And look at Shawn Michaels' face. Does he look like he's thinking about getting in there to try to help his partner? Not to me. I think he likes what he sees, JR. I think Shawn Michaels is enjoying this.
Well, thank you, Karnak, for reading his mind. I'm not so sure that's what Shawn Michaels is thinking.
Read your mind, but the print's too small. Oh, look at this.
Benoit's lower back really being isolated and punished here. Just Batista hammering away at another clubbing forearm. And now just manhandling Benoit back in the corner.
Oh.
And Benoit falls down now. Benoit.
Well, you can't turn your back on Benoit, not even for a second. You can't let him have a moment to rest. The big man is down.
Benoit got the enziguri, knocking Batista down. And Benoit's got to make the tag. Yeah. It's that simple.
So does Batista. Batista tag the legend killer.
You don't need to overanalyze it. Benoit needs to tag Shawn Michaels.
Yeah, but look at Shawn. You think he could at least reach his helping hand out?
Well, that
he's
is,
not even trying to tag in.
And that may be a little distressing not to point it out. And Orton gets the tag. Orton is in. Benoit could not get to his corner to make a tag.
And Shawn did not even try. He didn't even reach out an answer. Look out!
A suplex by Benoit. Now he's got a couple of more rolls. He's in his corner.
Look at Sean.
I'm not so sure Benoit even knows where he is right now.
Where's the outstretched hand from Michaels?
Shawn Michaels certainly knows where Michaels is.
I think if you reach that, you can tag now, Sean.
I don't want to believe that Michaels has got.
We're seeing it, believe it. Look at this, look at this.
What did I tell you? There's a tag.
Finally,
there's a tag by Michaels. Michaels hammering Orton with those right hands.
I guess it's better late than never.
Michaels inverted atomic drop and a clothesline knockdown and a right hand on Batista. Shawn Michaels quickening in a pace here.
Whoa.
Michaels getting on a roll, using Batista's own momentum to send Batista flying through the ropes to the floor.
Oh, the Legend Killer is in trouble here, big time.
Scoop slam by Michaels on Randy Orton.
I think the band may be about to be warming up here in a minute.
Shawn Michaels, high risk maneuver here. Will it pay? Oh, yes, it will. And Michaels now has regained the momentum for the Michaels Benoit tandem.
Well, he should have regained the momentum after he left. Chris Benoit gets the hell beat out of him. Listen.
Everybody can grab their instrument and begin playing with Michaels band. German suplex Randy Orton. And Benoit, who did not have he did not get the tag.
No, there was no tag. Come on, referee.
And Michaels knocking Batista off the apron. Got a little piece of, he got
Michaels
a piece of
Chris Benoit off the top rope.
Benoit, Michaels got a piece of Benoit. Got to think inadvertently. Nice flying forearm. And the nip up by the showstopper. Going for the cover. The hook of the leg. It should be. Oh, my God.
Oh, my. Wait a minute.
Benoit just came right off the top of that headbutt. But
who did he land? Did he land on?
Benoit covering Orton, but Benoit's not the legal man.
And oh, I knew that's what got him. Here we go. Here we go.
Come on, stop that.
What do you mean, stop it? Let him go. Let him beat the hell out of each other.
Benoit and Michaels now broken down into a brawl here. There's a roll-up by Orton. Orton got the pin.
Oh, look at this.
Well, Benoit and HBK.
There's no stopping this, JR. I told you these. Oh, look out.
Oh, Benoit looking for the crossface. Michael's going to fight like hell to get out of it.
Benoit's trying to cripple his own partner right here before our eyes.
And there's a world champion, Triple H.
It's Triple H. He's here.
Ever the opportunist, Triple H now opening up on Benoit.
Oh, look out.
And Michaels. Here comes, oh, that's Ric Flair. All of evolution here.
At WrestleMania.
Shawn Michaels being crucified here as Batista and Flair hold Michaels. The three shots by the champion and Triple H.
Well, listen, and listen to this Foley chant, but there's no Mick Foley to save anybody tonight.
God, another pedigree. One for Michaels, one for Benoit. It's all about the heavyweight championship of the world. And Triple H may be telling those men, that's as close as you're going to get to my heavyweight championship of the world. We'll find out at WrestleMania 20, where it all begins again, when these three men meet in the first ever triple threat match for the heavyweight championship of the world.
I still say we're getting a glimpse into the future right now. Triple H will dominate the triple threat at WrestleMania 20.
Well, you might be right. Can the game be beat? Can Benoit or HBK do it? We're going to find out at WrestleMania 20 in 13 days. 70-pounder driving Michael's face right into the canvas. Boy, that was impressive.
Every day, I tell them all, Michaels don't want to screw with me no more. Benoit don't want to screw with me no more. This ain't going nowhere, WrestleMania. This is mine. I'm keeping it. You're damn right. You're damn right. It ain't going nowhere.
You hurt him tonight. I'll tell you. Hurt him tonight.
Hold on, hold on.
Is that live?
Are you kidding me?
Is that live?
Are you kidding me? Guys, hey, can you believe this? Hey, crazy?
I knew he was stupid. I knew he was stupid, but I didn't know he was this stupid.
Hunter, Hunter, he's a glutton for punishment, man. He just, he doesn't get it. It's like it's time for Mick Foley's weekly beatdown or something.
Hey, this is good. This is good. You know what? A night's off to a hell of a start.
That's right, baby.
Finish it off in style.
Oh, oh,
finish
yeah.
this punk off. Get this over with, Randy. Tonight.
I have a feeling, baby.
This is going to be fun.
It's going to be good. We're going to have to beat it to his skull.
It's going to be too easy.
You got it, big man?
Right, baby.
Finish this off.
This is fun. This is party time.
It claims to be. In any event, Matt Hardy would like to beat Chris Benoit here tonight. And man, the first ever WrestleMania history threat match for the world title is this Sunday. And Matt Hardy looking for a bulldog countered. And there's that one German suplex, the waist lock.
Oh, no! That's two.
And Benoit looking for the trifecta here, the hat trick from the Canadian from Edmonton, Alberta.
And that's three, let him go, that's enough.
And
no!
And the takedown by Benoit. And there's a deadly Cooper crossface. The deadly, and Hardy casts out. Hardy casts out. And Benoit with a hard fought quick victory here.
Here is your winner by submission, Chris Benoit.
Man, what an opportunity for Chris Benoit, King.
Boy, I know it, and I don't care who you are. When the crippler crossface gets the fight, you got to tap out, whether you're Shawn Michaels or even Triple H.
You got to really wonder what's going through the mind right now of Chris Benoit. What must he be thinking?
Hey, I got a great idea if inquiring minds want to know. Why don't you go ask him, JR? Don't just sit here. Go down there and ask him.
I don't think that's a bad idea.
Are you really going to do it?
I think I will.
Really?
I think I will. I'll go right now.
All right, go ahead. Well, I guess we'll be back with JR in the ring with Chris Benoit. And you'll put the Crippler Crossface on JR.
You're in the main event at WrestleMania in Madison Square Garden, and you're going to fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. Two awesome obstacles, the biggest you've ever had, Shawn Michaels and the world's champion Triple H. What is going through your head as it relates to this Sunday at WrestleMania?
Well, it's pretty cut and dry, JR. 18 years, my entire career, everything I have ever sacrificed in this ring will all be defined in one evening in Madison Square Garden at WrestleMania 20. I'm gonna be walking into the ring with two of the greatest stars in the business today, HBK Shawn Michaels, and the world champion, Triple H. And I will be stepping out of that ring with that world title around my waist.
Without a doubt, you never faced two men in one match that...
These guys could go any second.
Chris? I came out here to let you know that there isn't anybody that respects what you've accomplished over the last 18 years more than Shawn Michaels. And I know this Sunday at Madison Square Garden, you're looking to fulfill a lifelong dream. I respect and appreciate that, but for me, it's about ending a nearly 10-year grudge with Triple H. And unfortunately for you, Chris Benoit, the way that I'm going to do that is by walking out of WrestleMania 20, the World Heavyweight Champion.
Wow.
Grudges. 10 years, unfortunately for me, hell, it ain't about that. But there's one thing we both agree to disagree on,
And that's who's gonna be walking out of the Garden with that world title around their waist. The one thing we do share, though, is we both feel strongly, we both are passionate about the fact that Triple H will not be the one walking out of the Garden with the title around his waist.
Well then, I guess that means good luck.
At least they agreed on something. They're shaking hands.
For you, I'm so happy for the two of you that you can come out here and agree on things and shake hands and be all buddy buddy. That's nice. Let me tell you where I stand on this whole thing. I agree with anybody who thinks this whole thing is a bunch of crap. Oh. The fact that I've got to defend the world championship against two men in one night. I also agree with anybody that thinks it's a bunch of crap that the two of you just stood in that ring and made a pact to gang up, basically, that no matter what happens between the two of you, that I walk out of WrestleMania without the World Heavyweight Championship.
That's a good point. They did. They made a pact.
Oh, you like that, don't you, huh? You like that? You like the fact that I might walk out of WrestleMania without the championship?
Get used to disappointment.
Oh.
And the two of you better get used to disappointment too. Because the one thing you're failing to realize is that I am the guy that always overcomes the odds. You're failing to realize that I am the guy that takes an opportunity that no matter how small it is, I will twist it and manipulate it until it becomes my advantage. You see, and I don't hesitate at all when I say this, I am the best that there is. I am the World Heavyweight Champion. And I have beaten them all, Jack. And you know how I've done it? Because I've always found a way to have an edge. So let me tell you what my edge is gonna be this Sunday. Because my edge this Sunday is gonna be the one thing that makes the two of you as good as you are. And that's your ego. You see, because it's your ego, Sean, that will make it impossible for Chris Benoit to become world champion. And it's your ego, Benoit, that will make it impossible for Shawn Michaels to become world champion. Yeah. Look at each other, guys. Look deep inside each other and see the truth. Because I think it is the one thing that the three of us can even agree on. And that is the fact that this Sunday, WrestleMania 20, Madison Square Garden, with the World Heavyweight Championship on the line, your egos will be all the edge I need.